Student family, welcome back to another video. I hope you're all doing well. I hope you're all doing good. And if you're new here, hello, my name's Kimberly and I hope you subscribe. Turn your bell notifications on to get notified every single time that I upload and give this video a massive thumbs up to be a part of my weight loss journey channel. Now, as you guys can tell from the title of today's video, I am doing my most requested video ever. Like, oh my goodness, every time I post a picture on Instagram or do a video talking about other things, the one thing that commonly gets requested again and again and again is please do a video on how you lost your inner thigh fat specifically. Also guys, if you'd like to come over and follow me on Instagram, I have a personal Instagram page as well as an inspirational fitness page on Instagram as well. Don't forget to give this video a massive thumbs up if you want to see what I eat in a day. I've just started university, so I've just been trying to settle in and nail and crack down on my work. But now that I'm a little bit more available, do let me know if you want to see that and I can film what I eat in a day, because I know you guys love the food side of things as well. For anyone who's new here and doesn't know, I went on a 40 pound weight loss journey. One of the main catalysts of me losing weight was the fact that I wanted to reduce my thigh fat. And we love big thighs on this channel, so if you're someone who has bigger thighs, or maybe your thighs even look like what my thighs looked like at the beginning, every person's body shape is beautiful, so we love thighs on this channel. This is just for people who say you just set yourself a personal goal of slimming down your thighs and you want a few more extra tips because you may be stuck or want to add to the tips that you have already. So today I'm going to be giving you the 411. So for people who don't know, when your distribution of where your fat goes, inner thighs is where the thigh fat normally builds up. So when we're talking about these inner thigh fat exercises, actually it's very essential for you to know the ones that are really, really working well, because it builds up in the inner thighs and then it circulates around the rest of the thigh. So this one's perfect for anyone who wants to slim down their legs. When my thighs were on the bigger side, they used to, every piece of trousers, shorts, leggings, anything would always ride up in the middle. Like, I just want to wear shorts, I just want to wear like a one suit, I just want to wear trousers without it raising in the middle. So that was my major catalyst, and it was just the inner thigh fat. The inner thigh fat, I think it's because it moves a lot more than the tougher areas of your leg. So again, the toning will help with the reduction of that moving, because then what it does is it rises your shorts, it rises your trousers in the middle, and you end up having leg rub for the rest of the day. You're like, why did I wear these shorts? That's what made me motivated to do so. So today I'm going to be giving you the videos and the tips that I used to do that. Also, you cannot spot reduce fat loss. So when we talk about these thigh slimming and these thigh slimming tips, build up fat in that area and your body chooses to place it in that area. Everybody places fat in different places. So if you're someone who predominantly gets fat in their thighs, what happens is you're now losing the muscle in your thighs and having a larger percentage of fat in that area. The only way to really, really reduce that is your calorie deficit, is losing weight all over. As a result, your thighs will slim down with you. However, you can also aim to build up muscle in that area to tone your fat down. You can reduce the fat in that area and increase the muscle percentage, which gives you that leaner look. And that is what we're talking about, that's what we mean. So it's really, really important, that's something to do, to have your leg day, to have your arm day, to have your belly day. All these days do really make a difference and they really, really count, because you're building up muscle in that area, the muscle tissue, which will then burn the fat, and it'll burn fat in your sleep, and that's what's so important. So these are the tips to make your journey and process much, much easier. Now, when it comes to exercise, you guys ask me which workouts are going to be so effective, because it really, really matters. Having a good workout is the difference between you working out every single day and having no luck and having actual luck. So I'm going to give you guys the videos that I used. We've got Chloe Ting, we've got Lily Sabria, and we've got Emmy Wong. Video number one. You guys know I started off my thigh slimming journey with Chloe Ting. However, when I was trying to look for inner thigh fat, I was like, okay, specifically, we need to look at inner thigh fat. This is where, you know, the area that I want to reduce the most. Even if I don't have this massive transformation, which luckily I ended up having in the end, I then went on to finding this Chloe Ting video. Now, this Chloe Ting video is absolutely fantastic. You guys know how much I love Chloe Ting. But also what I love about it is that if you're hesitant or wanting to know whether or not to do a Chloe Ting video, there are so many transformations on YouTube that have done her videos before. Specifically, it's this movement here. When incorporated into your thigh workouts, that's what targets thigh fat. When you look at the sciences behind thigh fat, it's really this. You know, when you're 5 seconds in and you feel that heavy burn, you're like, I've been doing this for 5 seconds. Why is it burning already? That is because of that movement. And you want to really incorporate that and continue on doing that. What I actually ended up doing is I use this video, but plucked out specific exercises within this video. And I would do them while watching TV during the ad break, 5 minutes before work, 5 minutes after work, you know, all these types of things. You can do it in your spare time. And I think it's really important to know that when you find this specific movement as well, to continue doing it throughout the day. And if you're feeling that burn, inner thigh high fat is really, really about feeling that burn. And I'm so adamant on that because it's the higher percentage of fat in the when it comes to the body. A lot of people, that is where the highest amount of fat is located, want to burn that fat. You want to make the fat cry. So it's really, really important to know you're going to get that burn with this movement. After that, I did Chloe Ting predominantly for about a month and a half. And then I was like, okay, I'm really content. And out of the woodworks came someone called Lily Sabri. I've recently done like an ab challenge on Lily Sabri, but never really talked about my thigh slimming journey with Lily Sabri. I've only ever spoken about Chloe Ting. However, Lily Sabri ones, I found a lot more harder and extensive to Chloe Ting. When I was doing Chloe Ting, they burnt a lot because I just started my thigh slimming journey. My thighs weren't actually used to working out at all. So then when I moved on to Lily Sabri, I found them a lot harder, more challenging, and a lot more muscle and cardio incorporated. When I tell you guys that it's important to have muscle and cardio, build up the muscle, the cardio will come and shake off the fat quicker. So that combination is what creates the best shredding, the best lean process, having the muscle and having the cardio. And that's what I found a lot of with Lily Sabri. In her videos, it's this specific video that changed everything for me. And that was the one I kept repeating. I didn't actually change videos after that, apart from one other video. But this is the main one that I used again and again continuously after that. And I alternated because Chloe Ting and Lily Sabri videos are so short. I alternated again. One day I'll do Lily Sabri, one day I'll do Chloe Ting, the next day I'll do both. And I did that again and again for a month. And it was this specific movement within Lily Sabri that I hadn't seen anyone else really, really do that nailed it for me, that would make that burn. After having done Chloe Ting for so long, I was like, what's gonna make my legs burn now? And it really, really was this Lily Sabri movement. And I'm forever grateful for it because it helped me in my transformation. Then I found Emmy Wong. Now I spoke about this previously in my other video. I actually found Emmy Wong because there was a period of time where everyone was doing Emmy Wong transformations. So many YouTubers, small, big, medium, were showing their transformations of Emmy Wong leg workouts. I was like, I need to get on this action. I was like, who is Emmy Wong? Someone please tell me who Emmy Wong is. So I ended up doing my research, and of course, majority and large amount of her videos were thigh slimming videos, which was perfect for me because I was adamant to continue this thigh slimming journey and find something that will really, really challenge me. Because one of the things with me is I need something that is going to be harder than the last thing. I need it to be intensive and I need to see that it's working. This Emmy Wong video is what really, really did that for me. And when I look at the specific videos that I did, it was this reoccurring video that really, really burnt my legs every single day. Like when I was doing it on Zoom with my friends or in their house, but everyone would be like, what is it that you're doing? And why are you like in so much pain? I was like, it burns. It really, really challenges me. And I love having someone like Emmy Wong motivate you throughout the video as well. She's so clear and concise. And it was this specific movement that it's really going to make it burn for you. The reason why I isolate and show you guys specific movements is because if you haven't got time, for example, to do the full video and you want to keep your momentum, from my experience, this specific movement really creates that burn for me. So you can do it if you don't have time to do the full video, or you can't have the video playing out loud or anything like that. Do this movement in your breaks, while watching a movie, while doing whatever you're doing, while studying, listening to music. This is really, really good for you, and it makes that burn. And it's honestly what allowed me to go from never, ever, ever wearing shorts to now I wear shorts all the time. Like even right now, I'm wearing shorts. You probably can't see, but I'm wearing shorts. If you guys want to go on your thigh slimming journey, these videos that I use really, really changed all for me. I always like to say as a disclaimer, remember, like I said in the beginning, weight loss cannot be spot reduced. So you do need to go on a calorie deficit and lose the weight all around, unless you just want to go on a toning journey. Even if you're on a toning journey, you want to be incorporating that deficit in cardio in order to remove the fat faster. Otherwise, it's going to take forever. So that is honestly, honestly what I did, and it really, really helped for me. If you have enjoyed this video, you want to see, let's say, a what I eat in a day, give this video a massive thumbs up. And don't forget to check out my weight loss plans in the description. We have a sale on currently. And don't forget to come over and check out my inspirational fitness page on Instagram and my personal Instagram page as well. Now, I love you guys so much, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Bye, guys.